Oklahoma State turns to the crimson cream of Oklahoma. The Sooner fans now out in full force as we get set, get ready for our game two here from the Ford Center tonight. Hoops presented by K Jewelers continues tonight from the Ford Center in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, and it is the 70th O'Reilly Auto Parts All College Classic. Now it's the Mountaineers of West Virginia and the Sooners of Oklahoma. Welcome back inside Ford Center, everybody. Brad Nessler, Fran Fraschilla. This is going to be an interesting contrast in styles. First game went to Oklahoma State over Tennessee. Now you've got an OU team that likes to pound it down low, and you've got a great shooting club in the Mountaineers of West Virginia. It's going to be different.
Well, contrasting styles is an understatement, because Oklahoma out-rebounds its opponents by 15. On the other hand, West Virginia, Brad, more of an execution team. They knock down 11 threes a game.
And 101 threes made already in the season. Find somebody else in the country that will do that. With our star watch, that in mind, here's two guys to watch for tonight in our star watch.
Well, Pittsnogle at 6'11", 255. He knocks down 43% of his shots from behind the arc. And, of course, Taj Gray, his work comes from inside the paint.
Let's take a look at our starting lineups for West Virginia. Pittsnogle, Gansey, Young, Herber, and Collins in the backcourt. Gray, Bookout, Godbold, Everett, and Neal for Calvin Sampson and the Sooners of Oklahoma, who went 25-8 a year ago. Calvin's done a great job on his stay at Norman in his 12th season. 265 wins. They went 12-4 in conference play last year. John Beilein, his fourth year on the other side, 61-43. His 28th year, though, as a head coach. Previous five were at Richmond. And now he's got a club that loves to... I just love watching shooters. This should be fun to watch tonight.
Well, they run an offense that's unique. A little bit of Princeton, but more what John Beilein calls his Lemoyne offense. That's where he got it when he was at Lemoyne College.
Jim Burr throws it up along with Tim Higgins and Curtis Shaw, our officials, and it'll be the Sooners of OU to start things off.
West Virginia opens in man, but you'll see some 1-3-1 zone today as well.
Trying to get a trap down in the corner, bring it back to Godbold on the outside. Everett fade away on the baseline. Tough shot, or would have been. Kept alive, though.
West Virginia double team Taj Gray early. Taj Gray not real proficient at passing out of the post.
Around a pick. Open jumper, and Neal knocks it down. Michael Neal, one of the newcomers to this conference. Averaging over 11 points a ball game, and he's got the opener for the Sooners. A little bit too strong on the overplay by Taj Green. He picks up a cheap foul.
Well, especially when you're 6'8 and about 230, 240, you don't want to foul 40 feet away from the basket.
Hard to stop that momentum.
That's
when you
right.
Get it going. Herber will inbound to J.D. Collins.
This is a unique offense, Brad. It's called a two-guard offense, and it's predicated on reading how the defense plays you.
What a cut by Herber in the pass from Pittsnogle, but it's out of bounds.
Good example right there. Neal overplayed Herber. He went back court, but the connection didn't work. Here comes that 1-3-1 zone. You don't see this very much over the course of a college season. Important to spread the ball.
Baseline jumper. In and out from Gray. Tip back in.
No one does that better than Kevin Bookout. The shot putter just caught it in his hand, one-handed, and lifted it softly off the board.
Bookout, a shot and discus man in the outdoor season. And he's a load. Collins picked up his dribble. Gansey now on the outside. And they'll reset him at the point. Backdoor cut, and nobody home.
And Kevin Bookout. Last three games, 74%. He's done this his whole career. Watch how softly he gets a piece of the ball and kisses it right off the backboard.
So Oklahoma out in front by four early.
What you have to do here, Brad, versus his 1-3-1 zone, spread it out, move the ball.
Wow, oh, what a perfect pass.
They worked on that today. They screened the back of the zone. And remember, the back man of the zone is J.D. Collins, only 5'11". Excellent execution to start the game. Watch the ball movement now. And then the backside screen on Herber. J.D. Collins is not going to contest that at 5'11".
That's about a 35-foot pass right on the money. Pittsnogle off the glass. Sweet shot.
Pittsnogle, more of a perimeter threat than a post-up player.
Gray on the outside and a cross-court pass and the lob underneath. Bookout couldn't find a handle on it. Neal does and gets it to Bookout. Finally, Gray finishes it off. Three chances for Oklahoma, and they finally make it pay underneath.
Well, this will be a test of wills tonight, because Gray and Bookout can pound you inside. West Virginia not with that kind of strength.
Collins has it stripped. Bookout picks up the loose ball. Three early turnovers for the Mountaineers. Pull up three. Goes! For Michael Neal.
Boy, that's important for Kelvin Sampson. Neal comes in with the reputation as a great shooter and has been in an early season slump.
You talk about a way to start. A 9-point OU lead.
This is basketball fans over
here. Brand, that what West Virginia had in mind.
Well, Oklahoma worked on attacking that zone at the shoot-around today, and they had a lot of different ways to go. So far, they've been successful. And of course, Michael Neal, junior college transfer, shows you how much range he's got.
Herber looking for a pick from Pittsnogle. On the drive, and a good one it is.
Five.
Johannes Herber, Joe Herber with his first basket of the night.
The guy that started every game of his career here at West Virginia, part of John Beilein's resurgence from Mountaineer basketball.
105th career start. It's pretty impressive in itself. Everett. Pull up from the elbow. And out of bounds to West Virginia.
Oklahoma will try to take away the entry passes, and that will leave them susceptible to backdoor cuts. But good pressure on the ball will negate some of that cutting as well.
Gansey underneath, nice adjustment in midair.
Well, again, that's just as good as a backdoor cut. The defender chased Gansey into the lane, and there was no way to get back in front.
So the Mountaineers settle in a little bit, cut it down to five. And they have a double team. Everett back over to Godbold, open jumper. Loose ball, Herber had it and got rid of it in time to Gansey.
Got a feeling you see a lot of floor burns tonight, Brad.
Three-pointer goes for Frank Young.
That is critical for West Virginia. Frank Young started in the Big East tournament when Tyrone Sally got sick a year ago. Banged some threes against Boston College. They need him to knock down that shot.
Mountaineers have scored seven straight to cut it to two. Oklahoma trying to answer with a three, and they're going to get an opportunity from the free throw line. Michael Neal will go to the stripe. His team leads by two with 15:06 to go first half. Oklahoma City, home of the O'Reilly Auto Parts Classic in its 70th year. 15:06 to go in the first half. Oklahoma leads by two, but the West Virginia offense is starting to wake up right now, Fran.
Well, it's a very difficult offense to guard. John Beilein has really worked on this offense. Now, keep your eye on this. If Michael Neal goes under the screen, Gansey will step back for the three. But because he chases Gansey, Gansey gets the open route to the basket and the easy basket. And Gansey really effective around the lane.
Gansey, the leading scorer, leading rebounder. He's number one in steals. He's number one in three-point shooting. And yet you hear a lot about number 34 coming out there, Pittsnogle. It might be because he's not as normal as some of the other guys.
6'11 guy with tattoos who can shoot from 40 feet. That's not necessarily normal.
Nope. Not something you see every day. Neal at the free throw line. Michael Neal out of Mesquite, Texas. First team junior college All-American last year at Lon Morris JC, and he's off to a great start. 6 points already.
know, he went 3 for 16 against Southern. Kelvin Sampson told us today almost every shot was wide open. So for him to get going is going to be really important for the Sooners.
He's got one of the first two. Remember, he was fouled in the act outside the arc, so 3 free throws for him. And currently a 3-point lead, Oklahoma.
With Book out and Gray inside, Brad, and Michael Neal will get a lot of open looks this year.
Got 2 out of 3. 7 points to lead Oklahoma early. Frank Young has the only 3 of the ball game for West Virginia. And they start lighting it up, though. They can put a string together. They've had back-to-back games of 13 threes, including their win over Duquesne, their last outing. They went 13 out of 31 in that one. Collins got it to Pittsnogle with a left hand.
Well, Terrell Everett would have helped Book out on the roll to the basket by Pittsnogle, except he tripped and fell down.
West Virginia hasn't missed a shot. 4 for 4 from the floor. Gray draws a crowd, doesn't he? Every time he touches it. But he got down low that time.
Well, they took advantage of that diagonal pass, which you have to do against this 1-3-1. The ball moves quicker from the pass than with the dribble against that zone.
Young will try 3 again. And Gray's got the rebound. Leaves it behind him for Terrell Everett. Wide open man right side, and the 3 won't go, and Young pulls it off the backside. Collins all the way. Offensive foul.
Well, this is called a big little screen. You see the pick and roll on Collins. Bookout helps for a second, but because Everett falls down, Bookout gets caught trailing Pittsnogle. Kevin with the easy basket.
Beeline in for the first time, the 6th man, first guy off the bench for West Virginia. Comes in along with Darris Nichols for the Mountaineers. Everett, nice feed down to Gray. Fake the shot. Gray's fouled on the baseline. I think it's going to be on Darris Nichols, who just checked in.
One of the weaknesses of this zone is that the point guard is at the back of the zone, Brad. So when the ball is in the middle of the court, he has to guard somebody like Gray.
He's giving away about 8 inches down there.
Say.
Hook out on the inside, and he walked with it. That's the Sooners' first turnover. Now Nichols running things at the point. Nice cut in the lane by Herber. The kick out for 3. They don't get the shot, and they don't get the tip either. They had good position. Both Herber and Gansey were there. Neither could tip it in. Ray will bring it back out on top at the 13-minute mark. Oklahoma leads by 4.
Oklahoma, West Virginia, back to man.
And a steal. And they've got numbers if they can get it out in the open court, but they end up with a foul instead.
Foul number 15, David Gottfold.
Don't forget, Holiday Hoops, presented by K Jewelers, continues on ESPN2 on Tuesday night. Should be an interesting matchup. Gonzaga with Adam Morrison against Memphis on the road. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. That'll be a dandy on the 27th?
Mm-hmm. And remember, Memphis did a real good job guarding J.J. Redick, so now they got another challenge in Morrison.
Nice cut on the baseline for Herber and a good look underneath.
When you dribble at a defender guarding his man, he turns to 10 and look at you with the ball. That time, the West Virginia player was able to slide back door.
Mountaineers all over the Sooners defensively, and they come up with another turnover. Pittsnogle with a steal. It's a 3-on-1, and he's going to lay it in. Tie game.
Not bad. 255 pounds. No one stopped Pittsnogle. Took it right to the rim.
We're tied at 15 apiece with 12 minutes to go in the first half. So West Virginia spotted Oklahoma a 9-point lead early at 11-2. They have battled back. And a whistle and a foul down on the baseline with 11:51 to go first half. Tie ball game here in Oklahoma City. 51 and a half, tied at 15 between West Virginia and Oklahoma. During the course of the season, the ESPN Family Networks will showcase great basketball, a great basketball moment from all 326 Division I schools. The countdown will take us from A to Z. And now, for ESPNU's pride of the program, tonight in the spotlight, we've got for you Eastern Michigan. Playing with four seniors in the starting lineup and using a small bench, Eastern Michigan showed a lot of heart. They captured the nation's attention during the NCAA tournament as a true Cinderella team, defeating Mississippi State. Then led by Marcus Kennedy, the Thompson twins Carl and Charles, Lorenzo Neely and Corey Hallis, EMU would upset Penn State in overtime to advance to the Sweet 16. Ben Braun's club.
A younger, spryer Ben Braun. It's only been 11 years.
Yeah. We were all younger and spryer.
11 years ago.
Yeah. 15-15. Boy, I just saw something cross on the ESPN scoreboard. Sean Bailey, a torn ACL for the Georgia Bulldogs, preparing for the Sugar Bowl. That's not going to help their passing game at it.
And you will be there.
I will be there. Oklahoma's Sooners will be in the Holiday Bowl. Bob Stoops' club leaves tomorrow. For that, we talked to Joe Castiglione, the athletic director, right before the game.
Mm-hmm.
Joe was talking a mile a minute. We grabbed our headsets and said, we got to work, Joe.
And West Virginia switched to a little 2-3 look, so three different defenses so far.
Baseline jumper, just a runner from Neal. Out of bounds to West Virginia.
This is good strategy, Brad, by John Beilein. Oklahoma, with that powerful inside game, only shoots 31% from behind the arc. And they're very satisfied to give them those shots.
Pittsnogle on the move. They try to get it back to him.
Good matchup with Bookout, huh? Two big guys.
No doubt.
Pretty agile, both of them.
Here's Beilein. Patrick, that is. One of the top six men in the country. Good three-point shooter. Going to dish it back outside to Herber for three, and he airballed it on the three.
Is that a hairball or an airball?
I don't know. One of those. And on the other end, Oklahoma connects. Nate Carter.
Yep. Transfer from UC Riverside. Sat out last year, kind of an in-between player. He'll help Kelvin Sampson's offense.
Beilein picked up his dribble, looking for some help. Gets it from Nichols. Lob underneath. Pittsnogle, tough catch, turns and delivers off the glass.
Boy, what was so good about that is he pivoted away from the double team and created a one-on-one situation. You really have to have good recognition of the rim and the backboard to make that shot.
There are a lot of guys that can automatically do that. I don't know if he can, but guys like Tim Duncan can make a living off it. Neal for three. Flanged it off the back of the iron. Scramble for the rebound. It'll be Oklahoma ball. Good hustle by Neal.
See, Brad, they can get that three later in the shot clock. They need to exploit the inside.
Trying to lob it on the baseline to Gray, and instead they throw it away. Taylor Griffin.
This takes some skill right here. Good defense. Watch the double come over quickly. Pittsnogle will recognize. Look at that spin move. Pivot. Kiss off the glass.
Fundamentally about as sound as it could come right there.
And he's kind of built like Duncan, too.
Yeah, a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
6'11", about 255. All the way goes Nichols, and he got it, and a foul.
You know, we've seen time and time again, one of the best ways to break down a defense is off dribble penetration, and Terrell Everett at 6'4", not able to keep his feet in front of Nichols.
Give Darius Nichols credit for keeping that thing tucked on his hip. It looked like he was going to have it stripped as he was fouled, and now West Virginia's got the lead for the first time, and he just hung with it, hung in midair. Chance for a three-point play. And he got the bounce. So all of a sudden, West Virginia trailing by nine early, and now they've got the lead. And getting the points off turnovers, and they almost came up with another one.
Now, when you see this kind of 1-3-1 zone, which is extended, you must move the ball. And so far, Oklahoma satisfied to shoot after one or two passes. And again, spread the defense out and make the ball move quicker than the players.
Pittsnogle gets a breather. Mm-hmm. Excuse me, Frank.
Yep. Now, this is a team that lost Tyrone Sally and Dior Fisher, two guys that were really athletic and really made this defense outstanding. Sally played at the top, Brad, and was really a nuisance in the zone.
They got the Sooners pushed a long ways away from the hoop right now. And they're going to come up. Almost came up with a turnover, and now a foul as Beilein got a little bit overly aggressive trying to chase down the loose ball.
Jarrell Everett overly aggressive as well with the dribble. Again, don't want to dribble through this kind of defense. But it's really hard to prepare for in just a couple days because they won't see this kind of defense probably the rest of the season.
Taj Gray getting a breather right now. Neal launches a three and out and in. His second three of the night. And he's got 10 points. 10 of the Sooners' 20 belong to Michael Neal.
That's a very good sign to have Neal heat up like this.
Nichols had an opening and weaves through the traffic on a runner. There's a good looking move.
Well, once again, the dribble penetration. He hesitated with the dribble, and that caused Everett to raise up to block the shot, and he slid by him to the rim.
Nichols already over his average. Neal gonna try another. Lookout had a hand on it, and now coming out of the pile is Nichols on the run for Beilein. Whoa, look out. Beilein goes down hard. He will go to the free throw line.
Well, textbook execution by Nichols here on the 2-on-1. Didn't give it up until he had the angle to get Beilein to the basket. Look at that. Perfect. And then the hard foul, and Patrick Beilein will shoot a pair.
Patrick Beilein has two throws.
Patrick has only shot 4 free throws so far this year. Hit 3. Good shooter, though. Great 3-point shooter.
Chris Walker.
Hard to believe with all the great players in West Virginia. 5 away from
being the all-time 3-point king.
Yeah. You'd expect a coach's son to be a good shooter. I would hope so.
Well, he missed the second. Griffin with a rebound. Oklahoma with Chris Walker in the lineup now. Along with Nate Carter. Some new faces in there, including Taylor Griffin. 10 on the shot clock. Walker almost had it blocked. Now the ball loose. Oklahoma turns it over.
Well, Walker has been turnover prone early in his career here at Oklahoma.
And a whistle, and he's going to be the man that picks up the foul as well. 23-20, West Virginia in front here in the first half. Our Holiday Hoops presented by Kay Jewelers. West Virginia here in the O'Reilly Auto Parts All-College Classic leads Oklahoma by 3. Reminder, NBA action continues Friday night on ESPN2. Back-to-back games at 8 Eastern. The Pacers and the Cavaliers get together. And at 10:30 Eastern, the Mavericks and the Sonics will tangle. Dirk Nowitzki and Ray Allen going head-to-head. Coverage starts 7:30 Eastern with Kia NBA Shootaround. Show with all the answers. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. Pittsnogle leading scorer with 8 for the Mountaineers, and Michael Neal has 10 for the Sooners of Oklahoma. Pittsnogle deep ball. Wow. He was way out there.
That's probably not. That's a little bit out of his range, especially coming right off the timeout with so much time on that shot clock.
Nichols trying to lob it into him. Tough catch. He made it, but drew a double team in a moment. Young just inside the 3-point line.
You know, very important for West Virginia to establish another scorer in that starting lineup. So Frank Young's quick start is a good sign.
Young only averaging about 8 points a ball game, and he's got 5 already. Carter picked up his dribble and looks for Walker. Oh, under 10 on the shot clock. Neal draws a crowd. Walker, now he finds Neal wide open for three.
Got it.
And they worked that very, very well. It was kind of a two-man game going for a while, but Neal knew where he wanted to be, and Walker knew that he did want it.
And again, against that zone, if you take your time, Walker with a nice job of exploiting.
And now a quick hand check foul on Michael Neal. West Virginia was down by as many as 9 early as Oklahoma jumped out to an 11-2 lead. But now here, the Mountaineers have battled back to lead 25-23 in the O'Reilly Auto Parts All-College Classic in Oklahoma City at the Ford Center. Calvin Sampson's team, 25 wins a year ago. They come in 6-1. John Beilein's Mountaineers 6-3 coming into this one. Their losses, though, to some pretty good clubs, Texas, Kentucky, and LSU. Herber got it on the outside jumper.
One of the things you notice about this offense, Brad, is everybody gets a chance to touch the basketball. Their assist turnover ratio is absolutely incredible.
They had 30 baskets against Duquesne. 22 came off assists the other night. That's pretty remarkable.
That sure is.
Trying to save it was Neal. West Virginia with a steal. Beilein thought about a three. Instead, it goes to Collins, and he hits it.
Collins, not known as a guy that takes a lot of shots. He's made his last 5 coming into tonight, but that's over 4 games, Brad.
His first basket of the night, and this is 98th career starts. This is a veteran team that West Virginia has, and they've showed it with a 7-point lead now.
Well, keep your eye on Patrick Beilein. He gives up the three to draw the defense, and then Collins wide open. And again, a guy that takes about 2 shots a game, a pure point guard, but he buries the open look.
You see the unselfishness of this club moving it around, and they lead by 7.
You know, Brad, coming into tonight, 175 assists and 87 turnovers. I can't imagine that there's any team in the country that has that 2-to-1 ratio.
Yeah, I don't know that there's any other team in the country, at least not too many. Backcourt, both have over 300 career assists. Collins and Herber, both over 300. In fact, Herber's close to 400. A lot of Pittsnogle signs. Pittsnogle and his wife, Heather. Expecting a little Pittsnogle, we understand. And as you said, might be the first kid that's born with tattoos. I thought that was great.
Oh, you're going to credit me with that.
You're the one that said it earlier today. I didn't think I could get it out of you on the air.
You just got everybody in Martinsburg, West Virginia, mad at me. Thanks.
Oh.
And he got his degree a couple days ago.
Yes, he did, as a matter of fact. Got the sheepskin on December 11th. That was quite a gown he was wearing. I don't think it went all the way to the floor. There we go.
Yep.
That's a proud moment for Kevin. Originally declared for the NBA draft and then withdrew. And 8 points tonight. He's done a great job. He's had some good moves on the inside and the outside.
Oh, he's perfect in John Beilein's motion system.
Gray back in the lineup for Oklahoma, and he doesn't get the basket, but he does draw the foul.
You know, it's interesting, Brad. One of the things you haven't said very much in the last 5 minutes is Gray or Book out inside. And Oklahoma has settled for a lot of jump shots. And while Neal has made a couple, the bread and butter of this offense, particularly lately, has been these 2 guys inside shooting over 70%.
Taj with 3 field goals tonight, in fact, coming into the game. He had hit 21 of his last 25 field goals since about the halfway point of the Villanova game. So, as you said, he's been tearing it up, 63% coming in. The preseason Big 12 conference selection is the man that they think will be player of the year. He's got 8 points, and he makes it a 5-point game. West Virginia in front, though, just under 5 to go first half.
And there's a zone. We thought that we might see it, and there it is, 2-3 zone. But you got to recognize shooters.
There's one on the baseline. They almost left alone, and now Herber does take the 3. Rebound kept alive. Young in close. And they won't get a third chance. Everett with a rebound for Oklahoma. Terrell just waiting for Bookout to get in the way and knocks it down. Says, thanks, big guy. Call it Blockout, Bookout, Blackout, whatever you want to call it. He gave enough room behind that big body to knock down the jumper.
You know, Bob Scoops would have liked that blocking.
He got that right. Nice ball movement. Pittsnogle for three, and he got it. Drains it on the outside. We talk about taking the wind right back out of you.
Oh, and what's so unusual about that zone offense is the guard cut through the lane to catch the ball, and the big guy was out on the perimeter in a deep corner.
Look out underneath. Gansey with a rebound. Gansey running the other way, and he's fouled by Godbold. Picks up his second foul. 3:36 remaining in the first half. Mountaineers here in Oklahoma City leading the Sooners by six.
Dave Revson in the studio alongside Steve Lavin and Rick Majerus. Coming up on the K Jewelers halftime reports, a couple unbeatens on the ropes. We'll let you know how those games come out. Thoughts on the first half, guys?
Well, the extended pickup point with the 1-3-1 and then kind of like getting a fake trap in there, that's got Oklahoma State slowed down and it's got them confused.
I'd like Brad and Franny to discuss what these two teams' chances are in terms of the Final Four. And also, 7.5 games into the season, still waiting for Kevin Blackhole Bookout to get an assist. I'm going to start calling him George McGinnis.
Stroud, Oklahoma, is going to be angry with Steve Lavin on all the things he does, guys.
Good one, Lav. 33-27, West Virginia. Oh, boy. Sanders here.
West Virginia. With everything Kevin Bookout does for these Sooners, Lavin wants him to pass it, too. I mean,
tell you what, we'll show the play that got Oklahoma its last basket here coming up shortly. He did everything and really nothing at the same time.
You're not calling him a big nothing,
no,
are you?
I'm not.
He's a big something. Good player.
Down, run on the inside of Oklahoma. Pittsnogle in front of him. And Oklahoma has had too many turnovers. Talk about Kevin Bookout. Now here he is.
Watch this little re-screen here. Everett tries to play hide-and-seek with the defender. Bookout just turns and pivots. Buries the defender under, and Everett gets the open look.
And a whistle and a foul away from the basket. Tim Higgins has spotted something. Grabbing jersey, I think.
Kevin Bookout, Oklahoma.
Bookout picks up his first foul.
18 fouls on the
So we just gave him some props, and he comes down and gets a foul on the other end and sends the other number 34 to the free throw line, Kevin Pittsnogle. Pittsnogle, an 84% free throw shooter. And I mentioned, your friend did earlier, he's got 1-3 tonight, but he's a 42% career three-point shooter, so he's got a pretty smooth stroke, and he's given his team a 10-point lead.
Rick Majerus said during the break, this 1-3-1 has bothered Oklahoma. You got to make the first two passes out top, and then you got to swing the ball. You can get that three-point shot later in the shot clock. You must explore the inside of the zone. Brad, the only two reasons they play zone is to keep it out of the inside and because you're poor shooters. And when you shoot those quick threes, it plays right into their hands.
This doesn't seem like Taj Gray. They've got to find a way to get him some touches. He's not really getting his hands on it much. Nichols penetrates, dishes out. Herber takes one step. Way up there is Gray for the rebound. The Oklahoma fans are a little bit stunned here. It's really quiet in this place. Look out underneath.
And that's where the ball has to go. When you get the ball to the heart of a zone, you really discourage the other team because that's where they don't want it to go, and that's why they play you zone.
Three from the corner, rims out. Loose ball is going to come free out to Beeline. So a fresh shot clock for West Virginia's. We just moved inside the two-minute mark. Nice backdoor cut and a great pass to Herber.
Well, and what happened? They recognized that the freshman, Austin Johnson, had just come in the game, and he had gotten a beat on a backdoor cut right before that. And they just set him up again.
Here is Johnson out on top, the freshman out of Amarillo, Texas. Neal, another three. He's going to keep putting it up there. Not that much. That's his fourth of the night, his 25th of the year.
Well, it's a little bit of fool's gold, because while he can really heat up, Oklahoma won't get back in this game unless Brookout and Gray get more touches.
Oklahoma fans are trying to come to life here to see if they can get a stop on West Virginia. B-line, a three is out of there. Brookout with a rebound. I just wonder if Neal's going to take a heat check if they get it in his hands. He's standing over there on the wing waiting for it. Here it comes. Short.
See, they're not going to be able to rely on Michael Neal shooting all those threes to get back in this game.
It's about a 13-second difference, shot clock and game clock.
Great thing about this offense, Brett, as I mentioned, everybody can handle the ball, and then your big guy can step away from the basket.
Gansey only one field goal in the first half, but he's done a lot of other things for his club. Five on the shot clock now. Herber, Austin on him, is going to drive and lay it up with a left hand. Nice move.
Well, Herber recognized the freshman has just come in the game a little cold, hasn't broken a sweat. He's able to take him off the dribble.
And Gray underneath. And a whistle and a foul.
Foul is number three. Patrick
Bilon. Bilon picks up his second foul.
17 fouls, West Virginia. At the line for Oklahoma, number 21.
Of those early OU possessions versus the zone where the ball moved, they got the lob to Gray.
Right.
They kept it off the floor, and they're going to need to go back at halftime and figure out a way to make sure their two horses touch it.
Taj trying to get in double figures. Neal's the only one in double figures for Oklahoma. Herber's got 10 for West Virginia, and Pittsnogle has 13. Gray got them both. And we're down to a second and change. West Virginia will just hold the ball and be happy with a 7-point halftime lead. Kevin Pittsnogle, 13 points. He's only missed one field goal. And the Mountaineers looking for their 7th win in 10 games this season. Oklahoma's fans a little bit shocked here in Oklahoma City. Send it now to the studio or ESPN2 studio. The K Jewelers halftime report.